Morning students, now today we will start our new chapter, that is chapter number 7, triangles. Students, we have studied about triangles and their various properties in earlier classes. In class 7, we know that a closed figure formed by three intersecting lines is called a triangle. Yes, tri means 3. A triangle has 3 sides, 3 angles and 3 vertices, right? In this chapter, we will study in detail about congruence of triangles, rule of congruence, and some more properties of triangles. We will study about inequalities in triangles. Students, we have already verified most of these properties in earlier classes. Now we will prove some of them, right? So here, first we need to understand when two objects are said to be congruent. What is the meaning of congruence, right? As we studied in class 7, there two conditions are there, shape and size. Two objects, two geometrical shape is congruent when they have same size and are equal in shape. Same size are identically similar, right? Same size means what? It's similar. Two angles are similar, two bangles are to be similar, two books are to be similar, or a contour, right? In size and shape. Or we can use the word concise, right? Understand what I'm saying? That is the meaning of congruence. If two shapes, like one is rectangle and one is square, size is not considered here, but the shape is different. One is rectangle and one is square. So here these two figures are not congruent. Understand? But if I make some rectangle with same dimensions, and if we put one of the to another completely overlap, yes or no? That is the meaning of congruence. So for any two objects, if they are congruent, it means they are equal in shape and size both. Understand? And here we discuss about the congruence of triangle. In this chapter, we will discuss about the congruence of triangle. When two triangles are said to be congruent. Before that, we here need to understand that what is the meaning of corresponding parts, as we already discussed in class 7, right? Here we have two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle BQR. And then what is the meaning of corresponding parts or correspondings? The symbol we use here for corresponding, that is, right? This is the symbol for a corresponding part. If side AB is 5 cm and QR is also 5 cm, it means what? It means AB corresponding QR. Right? If BC is equal to the QR, PR, it means BC corresponding PR. That is the meaning. And if AC is equal to the BQ, AC corresponding to. Similarly, when we talk about the angles, if angle A is equal to R, angle B is corresponding to angle Q, and angle C is corresponding to angle P, then we can write angle A is corresponding to angle R. Yes? Right? Now, when we talk about the congruence, right? What is the mean? How we did? Write symbolically written for a congruence. How we write? That is the symbol we use for congruence. When two triangles are congruent, we can write triangle ABC congruent triangle PQR. Triangle ABC congruent triangle PQR. But it depends on the corresponding parts, right? We always note write that triangle ABC congruent triangle BQR. It may AB triangle ABC congruent triangle QPR or RPQ, it depends on the corresponding parts. Yes or no? Now look at the screen. Look at the screen here and see this example given here. Now which of the triangle given below are congruent to triangle ABC? Here the triangle ABC have the dimensions 4.5, 4 and 5 respectively, right? Similarly, triangle PQR, triangle DEF and triangle MNR having the same dimensions, right? But look at here, in this triangle STU having all sides equal 5.5 centimeter each. Yes, that's why here triangle ABC congruent to triangle PQR, DEF and MNR, but not congruent to triangle STU. Understand? And how we write this congruence, we will discuss in the next video again. Okay, so this is all about the introduction part, and in the next concept we will discuss about some congruence criteria for triangle. Thank you.